I really don't be ashamed of literally nothing. Like, girl, the police told me they couldn't do anything. That goes for men, women, kids, babies, toddlers, snakes, dogs, cats, roaches, and rats. I hope y'all ready, because bitch, the Scorpios is coming a week storming. Stop asking me. I'm not doing a house tour. I had a be humble ass bitch. Like, and it's always the bitches that has never done anything to where they need to be humble. Oh, bitch, I ain't even told y'all the real good juicy motherfucking tea, bitch. Girl, this man looks me in my motherfucking face and asks me, can I suck it?
I like the Barbie. I'm a doll, but I still wanna party. Pink felt like I'm ready to bend. I'm a 10, so I pull an next 10. Like, Debbie, Stacey, Pinky, Pop. All of the Barbies is pretty
damn. All of the Barbies is bad. It's girls. And we can play 10. What's up, dear babes? It's gonna be Dior back for another freaking video. What's up? What's going on? What's going on, you guys? Let's see if I even like this intro. I honestly cannot stop cheesing, y'all. I am so excited to be back on camera. I literally haven't seen you guys in so long. I missed y'all so much. I am back for another freaking video. And for today's video, we are doing a where the has Kennedy been? I know y'all been like, oh my God, you moved. Oh my God, where's Alex? Oh my God, Barbie Palace. Oh my God, are you single? Oh my God, your boyfriend. So honestly, I have not posted on YouTube in months, and my next video will be my Puerto Rico vlog, so definitely make sure you guys stay tuned for that. I'm finally dropping all of the Puerto Rico footage. We had a time in Puerto Rico, so I cannot wait for you guys to see all of that fun footage. I didn't get a lot of the footage, but I did get a lot of footage. You guys will see that vlog coming very, very, very soon, but for today's video, I just want to catch you guys up. It's been a while. I just decided to get a little cute for you all. You know, like Barbie Palace on the wig. You know, I did my makeup or whatever. We got us a little wine. And we are going to get into the tea. I'm going to spill my own tea. Y'all know me, bitch. I'm an open book. I really don't be ashamed of literally nothing. Like, everything in my life happens for a fucking reason. It's all in my testimony. So, let's get into the last 6 months of my testimony, I guess you can kind of say. Last video I posted was 2 months ago when I was in New York, but I don't really think I showed me like at home at all. I'm literally like in an entire new place. So if you guys want to know more about where the city has been, what I've been up to, and what's been going on in my crazy life that literally needs to be a movie ASAP, keep on watching. So we're going to just start off with a sip of wine, because this video, it's about to be a long one, and it's about to be a juicy one. I'm gonna tell y'all all the good juicy tea that's literally been going on in my life for like the past, like honestly, since the beginning of this year. I feel like I haven't really been consistent with content this year at all. So please blame me, but y'all have been on my ass. Y'all literally been like so consistently on me. Shout out to the real Dior babes that see how far consistency can take a person. And y'all stay on me about posting my content, because y'all are really who I do it for. Like, I am so okay with just never posting again, just living my life, having my luxury. Like, I don't have to show it off at all. I'm suffice with that. But you guys definitely encouraged me to just, you know, stay on my grind. First things first, I clearly moved. Ah! I moved apartments, you guys, and there's so much that happened to get here. We'll talk about that, honey, because get into what happened. But I moved apartments. I now have a bigger apartment. This is the biggest apartment I've ever had. This is the most luxurious apartment I've ever had. This is the nicest apartment I've ever had. This is going to be my palace, like my Barbie palace, for the next few years of my life. I'm really excited about this journey. You guys are familiar with my last house. It was like a whole story with that, and I actually talked about it in my podcast, What's Tea with Kennedy. So if y'all missed that, definitely make sure y'all click on over and check out my podcast video. I think that's episode 2. Y'all have been also on me about the podcast. Episode 3 is coming very, very, very soon, y'all. What's Tea with Kennedy. I'd be excited to film it. I just really need to get the other mic so I can do the third episode with my mama, like I said I was, because I'm a woman of my word. But anyways, I moved apartments. Y'all know there was a lot of drama with the person whose name my last apartment was in. We've talked about it before. We won't talk about it again. I'm tired of indulging into negative things. I feel like when you feed into negativity, that's not doing nothing but welcoming that into your life. And even like if it's not intentionally, it's just unintentionally welcoming more negative shit to happen into your life because you're condoning it. Like, you're talking about it, you're feeding into it, you're giving it time. Like, does that make sense? So I try not to do that. And actually, I had moved all of my stuff into storage, right? So let me tell y'all one little story time. I was on Facebook dating. If you guys are on Facebook dating, I say that Facebook dating is cool, but I would just say be super, 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 super precautious and please stay safe. So I was on Facebook dating. I had met like a lot of guys on there. I don't really give my number out a lot, but I ended up giving my number to this one guy. You wanna know what's super crazy? My friend Christopher was literally like, don't give him your number. And in the back of my head, I'm just thinking like, you know what? It's just my number. Like, I gave my number to this guy on Facebook dating and I didn't think anything of it. So the next day or like a day or two later, he ended up asking me, did I want to bubbles? If you guys are not familiar with what bubbles is like marijuana, you know, like bubbles, that's what bubbles is. So he was like, oh, like you want, he didn't say bubbles, but that's what I call it, that's like my code word for it. So he was like, oh, do you want a bubbles, da, da, da. And I was like, yeah, sure. But mind you, I don't have any furniture in my apartment at all, so I'm thinking like, oh, like, you know, I'll go downstairs, like we'll sit in your car, like we may go to the rooftop of my apartment, but like you're not coming to my apartment because there's literally even nowhere for you to sit. It was literally only a bed in my apartment. Asked me like, where do I live? So I give him like an idea of where I live, and where I live, there wasn't really like too many apartments around it. I live by Atlantic Station. I can talk about it now because bitch, I don't live there no more. So I was like, oh yeah, I live like right behind Atlantic Station. So he was like, oh, you live at the apartments by Target or like the ones on the other side of the bridge. Da-da-da. So like, he knows the area. So I'm not thinking much of it. I'm just like, oh yeah, I live at the one like on the other side of the bridge. Da-da-da-da-da. So that was that, and then I ended up starting to do my hair. Like, I had took the wig that I had on off, and then I put another wig on. I started doing my wig, and I was like, oh, well, like, I know I can't link with the nigga, like, without no wig on. So, like, let me finish doing my wig. And he was texting and calling me, like, as I'm doing my hair. So, I'm literally sitting here, and I'm like, okay, I know I said I would link with you, but, like, there is nothing that I can do without a wig on my head. Like, I'm literally bald-headed. Didn't you have a bonnet on? Like, didn't you have a wig cap on, bitch? You understand what I'm saying? So there was nothing I could have done. So in my head, I'm thinking, okay, well, just reply to him when you get done with your hair. So he starts calling me, like, back to back. Then he starts, like, texting me. And then, randomly, he stops. Girl, like, not even 5 minutes later, I start getting random texts, random calls from fucking so many different text now numbers, friend. Probably like the most frightening 2 weeks of my entire fucking life. I've never linked, never seen him a day in my life. I swear to God. Never met him a day in my life. He literally turned into a full-on stalker. He was blowing my phone up like, bitch, why the fuck would you do that? Bitch, I know where the fuck you live at. Da-da-da-da-da. So I started texting him back and I'm like, why did you get weird? Like, I literally just wanted to finish my hair first. And when I tell you, for literally like 2 weeks, he harassed the fuck out of me. He went and searched me up on TikTok, found my TikTok, went and was watching my live. Then he like goes on my website, barbiepalace.com. Make sure y'all check out Barbie Palace, period. he goes on barbiepalace.com, and you know, I used to do pickup on the website. If you guys are wondering why we no longer offer pickup in Atlanta, it's because I literally had an entire fucking stalker. He went on the website to get the office address, and he's trying to like use that against me. And I'm like, nigga, all my followers can get my office address. Like, that's not a scare to me. But to me, the fact that you know where I lay my head, you can watch me on live and not know who, like what account you're watching me from, so I can't even block it. And even if I do, you're probably just gonna go create another account. He was texting me like screenshots of me on live, saying he's gonna come to the office and like unalive me, like seeing he know where, like he's gonna get me when I'm walking my dog, and like, yeah, blah, blah. Y'all know I have a Glock, so I was a little worried. But then I'm like, okay, I'm not really that worried. But it got to a point where I literally was in the office working late, and my followers were so worried for me. They was like, Kennedy, do not, like, you either need to go home now, like, you need to call somebody, you know, like, Kennedy, you, I don't like you in this situation. I'm like, bitch, I'm good. So he sent me so many threats that I ended up calling the police to my office. I showed the police everything. I told them everything. Girl, the police told me they couldn't do anything. Basically, it's blank text. They can't really prove that it's him that's sending these texts. And then he said that I would have to get a TPO, which is a temporary protection order. But then I called my brother Ty, who used to be a police officer, and he told me that in order to get a TPO, you need all of a person's personal information. Their address, their name, maybe like a job, their phone number, maybe like their email. I think like maybe like their mother's name or some shit like that. Like you need a lot of personal information in order to even file some shit like that. So I literally straight up asked the police officer. I was like, okay, so I have my own weapon. And if I was to see him and I felt like my life was in danger, and I was like, so what would happen then? And he was like, protect yourself. And I literally was like, okay, thanks for nothing. Tapped my key fob, went back in the building. And from there on, I was just like, bitch, if I ever see a motherfucking shadow of a bitch I feel like is him or any other motherfucking person that I feel like may put my motherfucking life in danger, bitch, you're getting popped, or bitch, at least getting that shit pulled out on you, and that's on my mama. So that was another reason why I'm like, damn, this nigga know where the fuck I live. Not exactly my exact apartment, but this nigga know where the fuck I live. So it's just like, girl, let's get the fuck up out of here. But then y'all also know that I was also just preparing because I feel like I have done so much in the past year. Literally, y'all know I started Barbie Palace now 15, I think today's the 24th. No, today's the 26th. So we missed our 15-month anniversary. But 2 days ago, Barbie Palace turned 15 months old. And my life has changed drastically. Like, yes, financially. But since I started Barbie Palace, my life has, like, tremendously changed. I have been able to help my family. I've been able to just a couple things that a bitch did. Just, you know, like lightly pat myself on the back because I feel like I rarely do this. But my mom's birthday was September 12th. I gave her $2,000 to put towards a new car. She's been complaining about how she really, really, really wants a cash car. So I'm like, here, girl, here go your little 2K for a little car. Like, see what you get, see what you buy. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people always ask me, like, oh, Kennedy, do you drive? Oh, Kennedy, do you have a car? Do you have a license? I don't have a car. I do have a driver's license, but I do not care to drive. I can go get a rental. I can go buy a car. I can go get a car note. I can go do all of these things. But me personally, there is like people ask me like, what's your dream car? I don't have a dream car. Like I don't dream of cars. Like when I close my eyes and go to sleep at night, it's not like me driving a car. Like I can't, like I don't dream of that. Like we don't have the same aspirations when it comes to that, and that's okay. I think so many of y'all think like when y'all see people with money, y'all push on them what y'all would do if y'all had their money or what y'all would do if y'all were in their shoes. But bitch, you're not me. You don't know me. Like you're not me, bitch, and I'm not too. I'm not gonna think like you and vice versa. So that's just like a really big thing that I just kind of like being like, girl, I don't give a fuck about no car. Like, I'm always lying. I'd be like, bitch, I don't know how to drive. I don't like driving. Bitch, I've driven plenty of times before. If you were real to your babe, bitch, you already know the tea. But it's just not something that I just truly care to have. Like, bitch, I love my driver, honey, sitting right in the back seat. Like, wait. Besides that, my little brother's birthday was September 20th, and he was complaining how his dad wasn't going to get him a game, or he asked his dad for a game or something. Girl, I went and bought him the PS5, like, the next day after he said something, so I bought him a PS5, and, like, the fucking expensive-ass... Since when is headset so expensive? Like my life has truly changed for the better. And, like, I was making money before, as you guys could see from, like, my vlogs, I guess you can say. But not to this extent, not consistently like this. And I just want to say shout-out to all the bitches that's been on BarbiePalace.com and that has spent even a penny on me and my website. I really appreciate you guys. I really love you guys for all the love and support on my website. If y'all have not already, y'all need to go on BarbiePalace.com. Pick y'all up some sweet rollers because, bitch, they're tea. They literally speak for themselves. But besides that, that's kind of like where I am business-wise. As far as content go, I'm trying to get back on my Zoom. You guys know now I have an office assistant and a driver. So a lot of times I don't have to be into the office. I don't have to do orders. She does a lot of them. You guys love seeing me pack up my orders. So I will never stop packing up orders. I will always go to the office. I will always put the shipping labels on the orders, but just certain stuff that I am just trying to allow somebody else to do. Y'all know I have super bad trust issues, so it's so hard for me to kind of just like let go and like let somebody else not run your business, but just do stuff for your business. And you know, like, essentially I always tell people, like, they're not gonna be like, oh well, so-and-so did this. They're gonna say Barbie Palace and Kennedy. Like, they're not thinking of my employees, or they're not thinking of who packed their order, or USPS. They're saying Barbie Palace didn't deliver their order. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, you just have to always make sure that people up under you are gonna always hold your business like up to the standard that you will always make sure that you hold it to. As you guys may or may not know, let's just talk about it now. I did get rid of Alex. If you guys don't know who Alex is, Alex was my 3-year-old Chihuahua and Terrier mix. I had him literally since he was like three, four weeks old. I don't want to get emotional. I feel like my son deserves the entire world. And I think that it became a problem for me when I realized that I couldn't necessarily give that to him all the time. And I don't even want to get too emotional, but bitch, if you have had a dog and you have built a connection with your animal day in and day out, like, bitch, you understand that connection. And giving him up probably had to be one of the hardest, like, bitch, it's low-key, like, worse than, like, a breakup. My followers always ask me, like, oh, what do you think of him? Bitch, I think of him every single morning, every single night, every single time I see a little piece of his hair just lingering around here somewhere. I always think of him. But giving him up was just the best thing that I had to do for him and me. I didn't have as enough time as I used to have. You guys know I got this super nice apartment and I'm really trying to keep up with it. Like, I do my damnedest every single day in and day out to make sure that my apartment stays clean. I'm making sure I'm not staining nothing. I'm making sure that my mental is staying right in here. And I think that that's a really big thing. A lot of y'all keep asking too, am I doing a house tour? Absolutely the fuck not! No! Stop asking me. I'm not doing a house tour. I will be doing a closet room or beauty room tour. That's what we're currently in. We're in my beauty room. I have it halfway set up at the moment. So I will be doing a tour of how I decorate this and make this all cute and girly and Barbie and Hello Kitty and pink and, you know, tea. But as far as like me doing a full walk through my house for safety reasons, for personal reasons, I don't think y'all understand. Like, y'all just like, oh, was she just showing up her house or it's not that big of a deal? Not even like, besides the safety thing, I'm like, I'm sure you guys kind of see the safety aspect of it. But for me, it's really just like, imagine welcoming tens of thousands of opinions into a place where only one bitch has to lay their head. I'm the only bitch that got a motherfucking sleep and snore and eat and shit and shave in here. Why the fuck would I want tens of thousands of people to have an opinion on that, to wish bad upon that? Like, I would just much rather keep my space to myself. And I think that if you a real, you will understand that and you will respect that. You will understand, you will respect that, bitch, you get what you get. If you catch me on live and I'm walking around here and I'm in a good mood, bitch, I might show you this whole motherfucking bench inch for inch. And bitch, if I wake up one day and say, hey, bitch, I ain't showing you a motherfucking corner, you look right here. It shouldn't be an issue with that. I think a lot of times you guys be like, oh, well, you're on social media. Oh, well, that's your job. Or, well, we have to talk about this. Or, oh, we have to. It's like, no, you don't. You don't have to comment that. Just because I'm on live and I'm opening up, you don't have to say that. Because if I go and just say the first motherfucking thing that came to my mind about your nasty neck, wide, dirty, disgusting looking ass bitch, I can't even think of the words to even offend you right now, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I really get into that, then I'm a mean girl and, oh, she's so nasty. Oh, who the fuck this bitch thinks she is? She thinks she have her too. You need to be humble. Be humble. Humble? Y'all remember when I was just on OnlyFans? Bitch, I was just a 17-year-old homeless person. I didn't have a home. I was just homeless when I was 20-something. What the fuck was to be humble when a bitch didn't have shit? Before the social media, before the veneers and the glitz and the glams and the nails and the wigs and the makeup, like, it wasn't a be humble then. I had a be humble ass bitch. Like, and it's always the bitches that has never done anything to where they need to be humble. So they always feel like they gotta put so much emphasis on another bitch being humble in their situation. Bitch, you ain't me and you ain't never been in my kind of situation. And even if you have, bitch, you ain't me in my situation. Once again, we're all different. We all think differently. We're all gonna do different shit. Anyways, I done got all off track. I love my son, Alex. You the best ever. I did get a call a couple weeks ago saying that he was adopted. Told them I didn't want any details. Okay, thank you. I appreciate you guys. But yeah, like I said, I think about him every single day, but just for the better of me and him. And also another thing that really did not sit right with me is having him just to say, oh, well, yeah, bitch, I got a dog. Oh, yeah, girl, I got a little chihuahua. Like, for a show dog. Like, he's so much more, that he deserves so much more than only being rubbed an hour a day, because, bitch, you're not even home half the motherfucking day. You understand what I'm saying? So, that's the tea with that. I'm so sad. And I know a lot of you guys have so many questions. Y'all like, where's Alice? Where are you? I did, and there's nothing you bitches could ever make me feel motherfucking bad about that. Okay? Okay, so I briefly talked about this in a TikTok the other day, girl, but I didn't really, like, go into depth about anything. So, I had met this guy. We called him Mr. Heck Yeah. He was a Caucasian man. I actually met him on Facebook dating. When I tell y'all, my account on Facebook dating is deleted. You will not catch Kennedy Dior on nobody's dating app. Bitch, if you... bitch, I... girl... I'm scarred for life, bitch. Get the fuck up off them dating apps, sister. Go outside. So anyways, I met the guy. I had his number for like a while ago. He owns a mechanical shop. So he's like a coy little white guy, you know, like he's a business owner. So we kind of like have that in common. A lot of conversations about like, you know, like business owners, being business owners, about like grants and, you know, like employees and taxes, you know, like boring shit like that. And just about like morals and like a lot of things like that. So we were supposed to go on a date and we planned to go on this date on this certain day. I was like getting my nails done. He called me probably like an hour, maybe like an hour and a half before the date. And said that he had to cancel because he had to do something at work or at his mechanical shop, which he owns. So, you know me being the owner and CEO of one of the biggest, I'm sorry. You know me being the owner and CEO of the biggest and the only one-stop online beauty supply shop, BarbiePalace.com. I understand how work can become a little overwhelming and you could get lost track of time and you have to stay a little longer. Like, I understand that, you know what I'm saying? But me being the bratty bitch that I am, standing on big motherfucking business, I will hope to take you on another date. I said, you won't have the chance. He said, to take you out again? I said, correct. He said, okay. I didn't reply because, bitch, sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Cause he thought shit was sweet. Why would you think that I would be okay with you canceling on me an hour before a motherfucking, I don't give a fuck who you was, what you had to do. You should have told them you was gonna change their motherfucking order tomorrow. I could give a, listen. So I ain't talked to him for like weeks, right? Weeks go by. I randomly get a text from this number and it says like, hey, how are you? And then I go to the thread, it's him. So I'm like, oh shit. I'm like, hey, how are you? What's up, Liam? Something ended up happening, but he ended up basically asking me that I want to go on a date. I want to say it was either the day after or the day after that when our actual date was. So in my new apartment, it's like attached to a restaurant. Like there's a restaurant like right downstairs. So I was just like, you know, it's a little convenient. Like we could just go to the restaurant downstairs, right? So I told him about the restaurant downstairs. He ended up coming over. He asked me like, where do he need to go and whatever. And then I'm just like, the restaurant, like go to the restaurant. So he ended up going downstairs and I just like had to walk downstairs real quick. And I went in there. I had on something super casual, like some jeans, a jean jacket, a cute little white top. And my Shane Justin bag, I think. Hey, girl, the date is going amazing, bitch. Like halfway through the date, I ended up starting a live. He wanted to take a picture with me. Like, he, like, asked to take a picture with me. Like, the picture that I have with him, he asked to take that picture with me. So, anyways, girl, I'm like, oh, okay, well, it's time to go upstairs. He, of course, he paid for the fucking check. Like, bitch, there was no way I would go out with a nigga. And I, first of all, I don't even pay, girl, anyways. The check ended up coming up to, like, two something. And then I think, like, with the tip, it was, like, three something. I don't like a nigga that, like, lets me see the check. I feel like that's a little classless, especially. But anyways, I ended up going upstairs. And I'm like, oh, okay, like, you want to walk me upstairs? You know what I'm saying? So he's like, sure. So I'm like, okay. So he walks me upstairs. He puts my food in the refrigerator. And he takes his shoes off. So I'm like, oh, I'm so tired. Oh, I'm so tired. I got a long day tomorrow. And he's just like, walking around the house with me. And I'm just like, okay. So the Q-tips are in my bathroom. So my bathroom is on that side of the house. The guest bathroom is on this side of the house. I got a Q-tip out of my bathroom, came on this side of the house to go to this bathroom to clean my ear out in the mirror when I could have just did it in that bathroom. He literally walked from the living room to my room, out of my room. He didn't even get to make it in the bathroom because I left out the bathroom so fast because I'm like, why the fuck is he still following me? He walked out of my room, into the living room, and into the guest bathroom with me, walks behind me, and like he's standing behind me as I'm standing in front of the sink, and he literally, friend, literally, he grabs my pussy area like this. So I like move his hand. I'm like, okay. And then like I walk out the bathroom. So then I walk in the kitchen and I walk like around the counter, and he literally walks around the counter too. So then I walk to the trash can by the door, and I had threw my Q-tip away because I was done cleaning my ears out at this point. And he literally, I swear to God, friend, I looked at him because he could see my face. Like, you know me, I cannot have my facial expressions. If y'all know me, y'all know I cannot have my facial expressions. Girl, this man looks me in my motherfucking face and asks me, can I suck it? And the first thing that came out of my mouth, I was literally like, before I could even break down what the fuck he had just said to me, I was like, and why the fuck would I want you to do that? Like, I literally made this. I'm like, and why? So he's like, you don't want that? And I was like, I think maybe it's time for you to go. Like, I'm getting a little tired. So he was like, really, babe? Like, are you sure you're okay? Like, da da da. Oh, I didn't even tell y'all how at the dinner, he like forced a kiss. It wasn't like, it was just like a little peck. So I let him fucking slide because I am a very pretty bitch with very voluptuous lips. So I let him motherfucking slide. But bitch, the forced kiss, and then you coming upstairs and you're literally asking me. You thought a $300 meal was gonna get you in my panties? And I went down there and I spent $200. It was just me alone. If that was the case, you should have just told me you was looking for some pussy, and I would have told you off rip, bitch, my minimum is 5 racks. 2,500. Half now, half when I get there. Girl, so when I tell y'all, I literally was like, this can't be real. Like, did this nigga really just, I mean, did this wigga really just ask me, like, did he just fix his fucking lips? And what really gets me is, like, you know, sometimes, like, you kind of get those vibes from a nigga that, like, a nigga just wants you for your body, or a nigga just trying to be freaky deaky with you. So it's like, okay, cool. But, like, bitch, we literally sat on the phone for hours, like, talking about business, talking about employees, talking about fucking business insurance and, like, different brokers for, like, we literally talked about so much. So for you to, like, come at me like that when you, like, and I could understand, and what I said was, I kind of excused his behavior a little bit, only a fucking little, because I feel like I was his first bad bitch. Like, he just kept saying, like, he kept thanking me for, like, coming out and saying, like, oh my God, you look so good. And mind you, like, I don't even think I had no makeup that night, bitch. Like, it was just, like, I don't know, like, it was just weird. It gave me, like, he was fangirling, and it's just, like, I really wasn't feeling it. It made me super uncomfortable, and I don't like nothing about it. Oh, bitch, I ain't even told y'all the real good, juicy motherfucking tea, bitch. Other night, I go out with Christopher. We meet up with Alyssa at this, like, food hall, have us a good little night. Our friend make us a drink. We had a frozen margarita from this Mexican spot. Leave that place, go to my mom's house because she was 15 minutes away, and my auntie and uncle were in town. They were all drinking at my mom's house with music. I'm like, oh, let's just pull up real quick. We're gonna say hey and leave. Go to my mama's house. Ended up getting drunk as a fucking skunk. I had, like, a little bit less than a half a bottle of Don Julio Reposado, and then my mother had 1800 Reposado, and then I drunk all my bottle. Apparently, I started drinking some of her bottle. We had shots of, well, we had some wine at her house, Bitch, we ended up going in her cooler. We teared the motherfucking moonshine fruit. Alyssa was eating the cherries. I was fucking the moonshine pineapples up. I had like 4 or 5 of the moonshine pineapples, bitch. When I tell you, we had a ball in my mama's house. I rarely even remember leaving my mama's house. We left my mom's house because we have a friend, me, Christopher, and Alyssa. We have a friend named Jada. She works at the U-Bar on Camp Creek. So they're like, oh, the U-Bar not too far. Like, let's just slide up there real quick. So when I get in Alyssa's car, we go to the U-Bar. I take my Blicky out of my purse. Because I can't go into the U-Bar with my Blicky. So I take my Blicky out of my purse in Alyssa's car. Go into the U-Bar. When we get into the U-Bar, our friend Jada is about to leave. She's like, oh, let me just like tip out real quick and then we can go. So she leaves. I don't like my female friends to drive by themselves. So if anytime we're like in a group and like we're all going to the same place, I try to drive with the female, like, just so they're not driving by themselves. So I ride in Jada's car to the racetrack gas station. I don't recall much, but I get out of either Jada's car or Christopher's car and I walk into racetrack on Camp Creek at 3:04 in the morning. I have my purse on my arm. Thank the Lord Christopher has a Tesla and it recorded everything, or else I would not even know half of this story. So I walked into racetrack at 3:04 in the morning with my purse on my arm. I walked out of racetrack at 3:11 that same morning without my purse on my arm. Mind you, I cannot tell you what the fuck happened after I saw Jada in the U-Bar. So next morning I wake up, I get on live, I'm talking shit, I'm like still like a little drunk, and I'm walking around my house and I can't find my purse. The whole time I'm thinking like, you know, like maybe it's just like thrown in a corner, or like maybe you just like was fucking drunk as fuck or something. So I'm up for like 2-3 hours, don't even know, Kennedy, you don't have a purse. So I call Christopher like, oh yeah, Christopher. Like, mind you, I'm still on live at the point. So I'm like, oh, Christopher. Like, yeah, you got my purse in your car, right? And he's like stuttering. And he's like, you don't remember last night, do you? And I'm like, yeah, Chris. Girl, you know how like you do like a little checklist. Like, you got my purse in your car. Like, it like made it all like fell under your seat or something. He's like, did you check the group chat? I'm like, Christopher, like, huh? So he's like, Kennedy, like, do you remember last night? And I'm like, bitch, what the fuck are you trying to say? So as he's saying this, I literally go and check my bank account. Because I'm like, wait a minute, like, something is not sounding right. So he's like, Kennedy, go check the chat. So I check the chat. It's the video that he took, like, from his car. You know, like, the Teslas record any motion in or around it. So it recorded us walking into the store and recorded us walking out of the store. And I'm just like, okay, so, like, what the fuck am I looking at? So he's like, we went into racetrack last night and we are separated at 2 points. When you first walked in and then when you was at the register with Alyssa. And I'm just like, Christopher, so what the fuck are you seeing? Long story short, I walked into racetrack at 3:04 in the morning. I went into the women's restroom. I set my pocketbook on the diaper changer in the big stall. I pissed. I left out of the stall, washed my hands, left out of the bathroom with no purse on my arm. I walked to self-checkout where I met up with Alyssa. Alyssa paid for everything. We walked out of the store. We left. So, as I'm literally sitting here in panic mode, mind you, I check all of my accounts. There's no money taken from my accounts. So, I'm like, okay, let me lock my cards real quick. Like, maybe a bitch didn't try it yet, or maybe a bitch didn't find it yet. But the first thing a bitch gonna do is go through your wallet and get your cards or see if you have some money in your wallet. Now, I had some cash in there, but it wasn't like no super crazy money. So in the purse, it was my black and gray vintage Coach bag that I literally thrifted. It's one of one, damn near. And then my vintage pink Christian Dior wallet that I gifted myself. And inside of that vintage pink Christian Dior wallet was Kennedy's passport that I just got because I had misplaced my ID in one of my purses. So I was carrying around my passport as my ID. Bitch. by the grace of God, Kennedy had taken her blicky out of said purse and put it in Alyssa's car. That's how she had that. By the grace of God, Kennedy has amazing friends. She dropped her house keys at her mother's house. Christopher picked them up and put them in another bag that I had in his car. In the other bag was my camera, my flash, and the keys that he put in there. So, at the end of the night, that I don't even remember, it pisses me off because I don't remember anything. Christopher said I was cursing him out, saying he always wanted to be somebody fucking daddy. Like, I honestly felt so bad. And I was just like, there's nobody to blame but yourself. Like, you're a grown-ass woman. You need to keep up with your own fucking shit. Lesson learned. So, I no longer have a passport. I no longer have an ID. I had to reorder all of my cards. One of my cards literally just got delivered yesterday. Or was it today? I think it was today. No, it was probably yesterday. So, I'm going to go pick that up from the office tomorrow. But that was definitely an eye-opening situation to me. And, of course, we went back to the store to try to find it. Christopher went and looked over the cameras. It was like a whole debacle. Last thing that I'm going to really talk about, and then we're going to go on to the next thing. But I was watching this video of Nicki Minaj, and she was basically like, when you're in somebody's face, and you're like, oh, girl, I love you. Oh, girl, I love your work. Oh, girl, like, I stand you. Oh, girl, I like your outfit. I like your hair. Da-da-da. And, like, you know, the person appreciates that or whatever, but then when you go home and you're like, ugh, like, that bitch ain't really about, like, oh, she thinks she all motherfucking that. Oh, this bitch. That, like, when you do negative shit behind a bitch back, that's not hurting that person. That person only saw what the fuck you showed them. But what you're not realizing is that, bitch, you're welcoming that negative energy back into your motherfucking life. You think that God don't see everything? God literally sees everything. He don't just see what the fuck I saw. He also saw what you did when you got home and how you rolled your eyes behind your head and how you deep down felt the complete fucking opposite of what you said out your mouth. So somebody on my live just asked me, how am I mentally and emotionally? And I think that that's a really good question. Thousands of people come in my comments and they inquire or they ask me about my hair, my lashes, my makeup, my skin, my nails, the stuff behind me. But bitch, you haven't even said, hey. You ain't even say, hey, girl, like, bitch, I see you alive. Like, what's your name? Like, how are you today? So I think that that's something that we should definitely normalize. So shout out to the girl on the live that asked me that. But me, mentally and emotionally, I think that I am not at 100%, but I am 100% committed to working towards getting to a very stable position. I think that where I am now, I have the perfect foundation for everything to be stable. I don't have too much stressing me out. I have a beautiful, comfortable home that I want to live and sleep and just stay in for the rest of my whole motherfucking life. You know, like, stuff like that. But I can absolutely sit here and say, bitch, I do get lonely sometimes. And I think that Alex played a really big part in why I might not have felt lonely. Because I would work all day. And then even when I was coming home, it wasn't 12 hours of quietness. Of literally hearing fucking nothing but bang. My owl, that's all a bitch here. Don't no words be said. Don't no words be said. But what I also am really stern on myself about is not becoming so dependent on other things to make me happy. If all of this shit was to go to shreds right now, like, bitch, we're supposed to be having a hurricane come to Atlanta. What the fuck you gonna do when all your phones go out? You can't get on live. You can't call your mama. You can't get on FaceTime with your friends. You can't call a nigga. Like, literally, what are you gonna do? So, bitch, if you're not comfortable and 100% safe and secure within yourself when you're by your fucking self, all of that other shit is just like add-ons, and that shit can easily be taken away from you within the blink of a fucking eye. So what I'm focusing on is making sure that I'm stable, I'm comfortable, but also I can get to a position to where I'm consistently pouring into myself. And I think that's just really just what I want. Like, I always tell y'all, bitch, this is further than I've ever dreamt of going. Like, there's no way in hell, like, this is the same girl that my mom kicked out when I was 17 years old. Like, it's just so mind-boggling to me. And if you would have told me, like, years ago that this would have been how you would have turned out, or this would have been how much money you would have made, or this would be the apartment that you're living in and the fucking luxury that you're living in, I would have literally told you, like, okay, girl, like, yeah, whatever, like, bitch, you lying. But, like, I honestly, I stayed down, I prayed, I was consistent. And I think that I was not consistent on YouTube, but bitch, give me my motherfucking props. I worked my set on TikTok, and I'm still working my set on TikTok, bitch. I'm working my motherfucking set on TikTok right motherfucking now. But I got myself to a point where now I can take a break, where now I can hire other people, and now I can take a fucking woosah and not get questioned and not feel like I had to validate my brand or validate why my prices are X, Y, and Z, or like explain or overly explain. Like, I am so comfortable with life right now. So thank you for asking me how I am mentally and physically. It's not the best that I've ever been, but I can definitely see me getting there in very, very, very soon. I think we all get lonely. I think we all want a companion, but I think that it's something that at this point in my life, I feel very conflicted when it comes to wanting a partner, because I really do want somebody. I want to be a lover girl. I want to be in love. I want to be in a relationship. I want to look forward to coming home to somebody or just having somebody to sleep with every night. But in the same breath, once again, I'm comfortable and I'm happy and I'm stable with how I am. So how dare me jeopardize that in any way, shape, or form by welcoming somebody in, by fucking somebody, by kissing somebody, by giving somebody your fucking number. You know what I'm saying? So I just have to think a little differently. And also another thing that I talk about a lot is I think a lot of times I be trying to humble myself. And I think it stems from, I can't really remember what it's called. It's like an actual phrase or word for it. Like, I tell y'all, I feel like I should have never gotten this far. It's called imposter syndrome. And it's basically like where I know that, okay, I've done X, Y, and Z to get to X, Y, and Z. But deep, deep, deep down, I feel like I don't deserve this. I feel like I'm not supposed to fucking have this. Does that make sense? And I think that that can really fuck with a person's mental, because it's like, oh my God, I'm so grateful. Oh my God, I love all of this shit. But then it's like, oh my God, like, how the fuck did I get this? Like, did I really work my ass off that hard? Or just like, was it luck? Or like, can I look like, so it just be a lot going on in my brain. And I just really just have to, you just have to get to like a good stable position. I would be very mad at myself if I was to welcome someone into my life and them to bring me stress and negativity and arguing and fighting. And bitch, knowing that, yeah, you're lonely now, but like, bitch, at least I didn't have to deal with that. At least I didn't have to feel like that from somebody else. So I think that that's just something comforting for me. And I think that in due time, honey, we'll have exactly what the fuck we've always dreamt of and prayed for. And it won't be a nigga that our sisters talk to. It won't be a nigga that you met on Facebook dating. It won't be any of that. I don't know who it's gonna be, bitch. I don't know how you gonna meet him. I don't know what the fuck the tea gonna be, but it's gonna be some tea. Anyways, enough of talking about the present and the past, honey. Let's get into the future and what the queen has in store. Now, you guys know I have been talking about for forever. If you guys follow me on TikTok, y'all know I stopped selling clothing on Barbie Palace months ago because I want to start my own clothing line, which I have now started. Period, bitch. We have our own custom clothing line, you guys. It's called Palace, P-A-L-A-C-E, with the little like asterisk over the E, Palace. It is your new loungewear, black owned loungewear brand. I am super excited for all the like new designs and products that I have coming. As of right now, we do have a two piece lounge set. I like to call it our skimmy set, kind of like Skims, like a skim set, skinny set. So it's a black long sleeve top with the thumb holes in the sleeve. It does have pink stitching all around it, and our logo is embroidered on the front of the pants and then on the back of the t-shirt. So the front of the t-shirt looks super seamless until you turn around to the back. The pants look super cute until you turn around to the front, right? So I'm super excited for the new colorways that we have coming. This winter, I want to drop like robes, like socks, and like some stuff that like I can incorporate for the men's to wear. So I'm super excited. And once again, these are like completely my designs, my ideas, my colorways, my, like, exactly what the fuck I want. So y'all know my two-piece sets I love wearing, my Juicy Couture sets, my velour sets. Like, I literally am going to create them, but in my own brand. So definitely make sure y'all stay tuned for all the new stuff that Palace has to offer. Palace will be exclusively sold on BarbiePalace.com. You guys know that is your new one-stop online beauty supply shop. You guys need to click the link down in the description box, and it should be across your screen as well. It's BarbiePalace.com. BarbiePalace.com. But besides that, you guys know my birthday is coming. Ah, it's almost Scorpio season. I hope y'all ready, because bitch, the Scorpios is coming a week storming. Let's not wish a storm upon us. You guys know, typically, I do my birthdays big every single year. I don't know, it's just something that my mother instilled in me. Every year for our birthday, we could have literally not gotten anything for Christmas, not gotten anything for fucking Easter, not gotten anything for any other time of the year. Bitch, if your birthday time came around, you best believe your mother, my mother, is going to make us feel special. So always, it don't matter if she literally had a dollar to her name, like, bitch, we somehow had a cake, we had a bag of clothes, we had a little toy here and there. That weekend we went out to the movies or the Chuck E. Cheese, or we've always done something for our birthday. So that's something that I kind of got from my mother. But this year, you guys know I'm turning 23. I am 22. I'm getting old, girl, like, oh! So this is my Jordan year, y'all. I'm turning 23 years old, so I'm super excited. And I was gonna do just like the typical Jordan party, you know, like everything Jordan, the black and red. But who would I be if I did some typical shit? Like, is that really like Kennedy Dior coded? Like, it just don't give me that. So I am having a Barbie Jordan themed sneaker ball. It's going to be Barbie. Everything's going to be pink, silver, glitter, all kind of shades of pink. And then you guys have to wear Jordans. Everybody has to wear Jordans. I'm not going to be wearing Jordans with my first dress. Yeah, I said first one. because I'm just a birthday bitch. I get to do what the fuck I want to do. And y'all have to listen to the motherfucking rules. And you will not be allowed at my party. I don't care how many tickets you bought or how much money you spent. You will not be allowed at my party if you do not have Jordans on your feet. That goes for men, women, kids, babies, toddlers, snakes, dogs, cats, roaches, and rats. Do you understand what I'm saying? Bitch, I'm not playing with y'all. So, everybody has to have on Jordans. It's not really like color-coded or color-themed, so you guys don't necessarily have to wear like pink or anything like that. Of course, both of my dresses are pink because I'm just an extra-ass bitch and everything has to be pink. But I'm having a super, super, super big party. It's like sneaker ball or adult prom attire. So all the girls will be wearing dresses and Jordans. All the guys will be having on tuxedos, ties with their Jordans and like suits and Jordans. So I'm really excited to see the girls put on their suits and ties and their gowns and their dresses and their skirts with their Jordans. Like, I'm really, really, really excited. Some people have already bought their flights to Atlanta for November 9th. I know my birthday is November 9th, 11:09. I'm vlogging the entire weekend, so definitely make sure y'all stay tuned for the birthday content, because y'all know it's gonna go shit fucking crazy. I literally have an event planner. I have like an entire like documentary style video dropping after my birthday. It'll kind of like be me preparing for my party, me living like my everyday life with Barbie Palace, me going to get my favorite ICI. It's gonna kind of be like documentary style. I'm not really recording a lot of the footage. I kind of have like the point of view from somebody else watching me. It's like me going to the vendors. So I really am excited to for you guys to see that. It's kind of just like the day in the life of Kennedy, but more of a documentary TV show, people following me around style. So I'm really excited for all the new content that I have dropping, you guys. I'm really gonna be super, super, super consistent, because I do not have to spend as many hours as I used to in the office doing Barbie Palace, because luckily you guys have given me the grace to still make the money that I make and not actually have to be there. I have employees packing up the orders. The product is still the same. Of course, I will always go in. I will always do my orders. I will always check emails. I will always do certain stuff. But it feels really good to be able to count on somebody else for that to be done. So definitely make sure y'all stay tuned for everything that I, for my birthday, and Barbie Palace, and Palace Stay, and my TikTok, and my YouTube, and my Instagram has up and coming, because it's a lot coming up, honey. And y'all know I always think over Scorpio season, so this year is no fucking different. But we have talked about everything that has been going on with the doll, honey. I want you guys to drop down below in the comments what the is some juicy tea that's been going on in your life. I may or may not read it in my next podcast or my next YouTube video, honey. And I may give you a little advice or what would I do or like what would you do or like what should you do? Like what would Kennedy do? That might be a good little video or something. But I love you guys so much. I cannot wait for you guys to see my new apartment and my new life and just come along this journey with me. You guys know every day is a learning experience for me. I never had a business owner to show me like, okay, this is how you run a business. This is how you do your taxes. This is how you do X, Y, and Z. So honestly, for me, being a business owner, being an influencer, making the most money that any bitch in your family has ever made, it's a little frightening, but it's kind of exciting. Like, I feel like I don't feel like there's a lot of pressure on my shoulders. I love y'all. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. If you guys like this video, make sure y'all give it a really big thumbs up. Drop a comment down below of any other video ideas you guys want to see from me. And I love you, dear babes, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye!